praise him
for the help,
for the help
of his countenance.
Of his countenance. In other words, he is my helper.
Yes.
And though people fail, he never failed. Somebody get Mark, first chapter, real quickly. Verse 35. Down through the 38.
And in the morning,
I got to quit before I flip. Read.
And in the morning, rising up and
breaking. It's going to take energy to last through what we are facing in America. And who's in charge? It's going to take some energy. Healthcare is on a chaos. Yes. The president, I don't know what he's doing.
Mark, first chapter, starting at the 35th verse.
Now listen, get this. I want you to get this. Get this. Because see, this is how people operate. Listen, now you read, read. Read along with the first thing. Read, read.
And in the morning.
In the morning.
Rising up at great. Rise. While before day, he went out.
Somebody shake your neighbor's hand like you're trying to shake that hand to the floor. And say, neighbor. The old people say, the early bird catches the worm. So Jesus got up early. He got up early. See, my kids are not early birds.
Nope.
The Bible says, charity begins at home and spreads abroad. If you want to get some stuff done, get up early. So here's now, get this. And then don't walk out, please don't stay with me. So Jesus got up early. And went out, because sometimes you need to get to yourself. Sometimes, David, giving you need to take a walk.
That's right. Early
in the morning. Sometimes you just need to get the thoughts together before you face the day. Woo! Finish reading. He got up early. Now here's the interesting thing. About inquisitive people,
yeah.
Nosy people. They're coming inquiring. What you doing? Read.
He went out and departed into a solitary place and there prayed. And Simon and they that were with him followed after him.
Now you don't need people to follow you when you need your moment.
That's right.
You don't need it. You don't need people to follow you when you want to have a close walk and talk with God. Now here they come now inquisitive, with a whole bunch of questions.
My God.
Where were you? And what you were doing. We got to quit.
My God.
And when they had found him, they said unto him, all men seek for thee.
Notice, they said, when they had found him. Somebody looking for you.
Yeah.
And they ain't looking you for you to, for the right reason. They just want to check and get in your business.
Uh-huh.
Read.
And he said unto them, let us go into the next towns, that I may preach there also, and therefore come I forth.
Everybody stand. Everybody stand. You see, and I'm sure that pastors and bishops, apostles and leaders here can understand that we who are leaders are always constantly pouring out.
Yeah.
We're constantly pouring out. Whether we're praying for folks,
amen,
or visiting people,
yes,
we are constantly pouring out. But it comes a time when we need somebody to pour back in us. And in other words, to continue what we are doing, we need to be replenished. You need an energy replenishing. Can I get a witness in here? Can I get somebody that can be transparent? That says sometimes you need to be replenished. I want to do a conference. Been in my spirit for about 3-4 years to do a rekindling conference. Rekindling. Read on, read on. That was it. Listen. Jesus needed to get away because they was constantly pulling on him.
Yes.
Sick. The broken.
Yes.
All kinds of things. And you can lose your energy if you don't stay focused.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Subject matter today. I want you to take this home with you. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, put this in the lunchbox.
Put this in the lunchbox.
And take it with you.
Take it with you.
Don't lose. Your spiritual
energy.
Don't lose it. You know what the Bible said, Ellen Reagan? The Bible said you did run well. You did run well, but who hindered you? Who was a family member? Was it a naysayer on the phone? Was it a hater? Was it a job? See, you know what I found out? If you want to do better, pray for better. God will change your work situation.
I'm losing. Prayer changes
that. Prayer will change our Sunday work schedule.
Praise God.
I work very closely with the Hasidic Jews. In fact, these I speak their language. They will not let nothing separate their self.
Yes.
They ain't going to answer no phone. They ain't going to turn on no lights.
Nothing.
When you lose your energy, you will not continue doing what you used to do.
Tell me about it.
And guess what?
Tell me about it.
I'm sorry to bust your bubble. But it will be evident when you lose your energy.
It will
be evident. Matter of fact, the closer you get to Jesus, there should be a renewing of the spirit.
Amen.
In you.
Yes. That's right.
Hallelujah.
Those people was no interest in songwriter that would say every day with Jesus.
Yes.
It's sweeter than the day before.
We're done. We're closing. Thank you, Jesus. Did you stand there? Don't lose your spiritual energy. And when you see somebody losing their energy, Christian the world.